Hi, I'm Christina from Milan Creative Co. and in today's tutorial I want to show you how you can make a tile pattern using Procreate and the symmetry tool. Before we get started, I want to set up the canvas. So tap the plus sign, select new canvas. I like to use inches, so I usually use 6 by 6 inches. I leave the DPI to 300 and you can see here the number of maximal layers. This is very important if you have many details in your illustrations and you need more than one layer. So I usually set the color profile as RGB, and if you want you can change the name of the canvas and tap create to create your new canvas. Next, we will have to set up the grid. So tap the wrench tool, select drawing guide, and then tap on edit drawing guide. So we have a few drawing guides here. What I'm looking for is the symmetry guide. And you can tap on options to see all the guides you have. So we have vertical, horizontal, quadrant, and radial. And for this, I want to use radial, which splits the canvas into 8 areas. When you select the symmetry tool, make sure that assisted drawing is turned on. This is what actually will help us create the pattern. When your drawing guides are set up, just tap done and you can see them here on the screen. So I'm going to select this color, and if you're wondering how this works, you can start by drawing a petal. And as you can see, we have 8 petals instead of only one. So everything that you draw, no matter where you draw, let's draw over here, will be replicated on all the other areas. I really love using the monoline brush for my illustrations. You can find this under calligraphy monoline. It's the basic brush that comes with Procreate. I also have a few custom mono brushes, but I really like the standard one. And I also have a color palette already selected, so I'm going to use this dark gray. And I'm going to zoom in to see what I'm doing and just draw a petal. And just like that, I already have a flower. So now I'm just going to add different elements to the drawing. Let's add something else over here. So this is going to be the center of our pattern. So I want to add a few more flowers. So I'm going to create something that will probably resemble a lotus flower. I really, really love using dots to add more details to my drawing. Also going to add a few circles over here on this line. I want to add another flower over here, and I'm going to start by drawing a petal. And then I want to add 2 more petals. If you don't like the lines, you can use the eraser to fix everything. And again, I want to add a few details to my flowers. What I would like to do is to add a little circle over here. So I'm going to create another layer and click on the layer and then select drawing assist. So when you add a new layer, you will always have to do this. And now I am going to use a sketching brush. I like the peppermint for sketches. It's not really important for this one. Try to create a circle, maybe like this. Yeah, that looks good. So now I am going to drag this under my main layer and go back to the calligraphy brushes and to my mono brush. And what I want to do is add just a little dot. And now I am going to swipe and delete the layer. So this is what we have so far. One more thing I want to do is add a small flower in the corner. So I also want to fill in the areas, so I am going to do like a basely shape. So we have enough elements in the center, so I'm just going to make a few swirls. Maybe some small flowers. So next I would like to color the shapes. So I'm going to go to layers and I am going to duplicate the layer just to make sure that I have a copy of the main layer. And then I am going to select this yellow, zoom in, and I am going to add color to this. So I'm going to go back to the previous layer and the dark gray, and let's just color this. I think I did that by mistake because I often drag my nails on the iPad and just leave many marks, but I actually love how it looks. Okay, this looks nice. So I want to make sure that I have the first layer selected. And let's use this light gray for the paisley. I'm just going to drag the color. Add a bit of yellow over here. It's looking good so far. Oh, I want a bit of pink, so I'm going to use this light pink. Let's use a darker pink for some of these leaves. Let's also add the background, so I'm going to add a new layer. And I have this off-white that I'm going to use for the background, like that. And now I just want to go over everything and add small details. I really love adding dots and maybe small flowers or small swirls just to make it a little bit more interesting and to fill in the empty spaces. This is my final pattern. Now what I like to do is to select all the layers, then group them. And I usually like to test the pattern to see how it looks if I have a repeat pattern. So I will duplicate the group I will make this one invisible and then flatten this one so I only have one layer. And to test it, I am going to create 3 more copies, then make all of them except the bottom one invisible, and I'm going to use the transform tool. When I use the transform tool, I make sure that uniform is selected and magnetics is also selected, and then I drag it to the middle of the canvas and then click on the transform tool to deselect it. Now I'm going to select the next one and I'm going to drag it from the lower left corner to the upper right corner. Let's do the same for the other two. So I'm going to close the drawing guide. And this is how my repeat pattern looks. Hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to see more, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.